Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved. Thus far, and grace will keep us on. Yes, it will. And grace will lead. Thank you, Lord. Amazing grace.
Once upon a time, there was a young basketball player who had dreams of becoming one of the greatest basketball players of all time.
He had the opportunity to go to the NBA and play against the greatest players in the world. That doesn't get you going, I don't think anything will. It's like a dream come true.
I couldn't even dream of this when I was a kid, you know, there's just no way possible. It's just, you know, just a blessing from above.
The joy of the game comes from just being out there and just playing. The competitive side of me feels like we can win every game that we play.
What I've learned is to always keep going. Do you love the process that gets you to that, those boring, agonizing moments? If you love that, then you know you found something that's really true to you.
You know, if you do the work, you work hard enough, dreams come true. Those times when you get up early and you work hard, those times when you stay up late and you work hard, those times when you don't feel like working, you're too tired, you don't want to push yourself, but you do it anyway, that is actually the dream.
If you're a fan of mine, you're a fan of winning. You're a fan of the Lakers. That's never going to change. Man, I gave my soul to this game, man. There's nothing more I could give.
I wanted to be one of the best basketball players to ever play, and anything else that was outside of that lane, I didn't have time for.
It's not about my jerseys that are hanging up there for me. You know, it's about the jerseys that were hanging up there before.
Growing up and watching all these great players play and learning so much from them, to now be a part of that wall, you know, means everything to me.
You get older, you start to understand that really it's about the next generation. That these championships do come and go, but the most important thing you can do is to pay everything that you learn forward to the next generation to come. And that's truly how you create something that lasts forever.
I love storytelling. You imagine like winning an Oscar, how ridiculous that would be.
And the Oscar goes to...
Unfortunately for us athletes, we've been pigeonholed into thinking that we can only be one thing. I'm here to show people that we can do much more than that. Winning an Oscar, winning the Emmy and the Annie, those are things that are showing other athletes that come after, no, there's more to this thing. The discipline, the commitment, the team and community, how do I take those lessons and move those here? Having that sharp focus is something that I got from the game of basketball.
You have to dance beautifully in the box that you are comfortable dancing in. My box was to be extremely ambitious within the sport of basketball. Your box is different than mine. Everybody has their own. It's your job to try to perfect it and make it as beautiful of a canvas as you can make it. And if you have done that, then you have lived a successful life. You have lived with Mamba mentality.
And being married to my wife, Vanessa's, it's fun. We have a good time together. I love her tremendously, but we're best friends too. That's a blessing.
When we were raising our daughters, one of the things that we teach them is you just gotta try your best. You just gotta give it your all, give it everything you have.
As parents, you gotta lead by example. If you want your kids to do whatever it is they wanna accomplish in life, you have to show them. I have four girls, so my mission is to make sure women have opportunities.
Our daughters will grow up understanding that they can be strong, they can be independent, they can be fierce.
I just love spending time with my family and just being a husband, being a father, being a goofball, just having a good time with my kids.
Thank you.
I grew up a diehard, I mean a diehard Laker fan. And to spend 20 years here, I mean, you can't write something better than this.
You got 19 or 20 years to play with the Lakers.
Yeah, 19 or 20 at least. Appreciating all this, you know, the journey that we've been on. You know, we've been through our ups and been through our downs. I think the most important part is that we all stayed together throughout. You guys will always be in my heart. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. God, I love you guys. What can I say? Mamba out.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand and remove your hats? The Lakers organization and the entire NBA family was devastated by the events Sunday morning in Calabasas. Lost in this unthinkable tragedy were husbands, wives, parents and children, teammates and coaches. As the entire world mourns, we want to remember and honor those 9 individuals. On the court, Kobe Bryant was one of the greatest players of all time. The future Hall of Famer was an 18-time All-Star. The 2008 NBA MVP, a 2-time Olympic gold medalist, and 5-time NBA champion off the court. Kobe was more than a basketball player. He was a beloved husband, an author, philanthropist, an Oscar, Emmy, and Annie Award winner, and most importantly, a father of 4 beautiful daughters. At this time, please join the Los Angeles Lakers, the Portland Trail Blazers, and the entire global basketball family in a 24.2-second moment of silence to honor the lives lost on Sunday. Laker Nation, thank you very much. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to honor the United States of America, will you please remain standing and remove your hats for the national anthem performed this evening by Boys to Men.
What so proudly we
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome LeBron James.
Before I get started on the speech that I have, I want to acknowledge all the lives that was lost Sunday morning. Alyssa Altabelli, John Altabelli, Carrie Altabelli, Peyton Chester, Sarah Chester, Christina Mauser, Ara Zabanya, Gianna Bryant, and Kobe Bryant. Now, I got something written down. You know, they asked me to kind of stay on course or whatever the case may be, but Laker Nation, man, I would be selling y'all short if I read off this shit, so I'm gonna go straight from the heart. The first thing that come to mind, man, is all about family. And as I look around this arena, we're all grieving, we're all hurt, we're all heartbroken. But when we're going through things like this, the best thing you can do is lean on the shoulders of your family. And from Sunday morning all the way to this point, now I heard about Laker Nation before I got here last year about how much of a family it is. And that is absolutely what I've seen this whole week, not only from the players, not only from the coaching staff, not only from the organization, but from everybody. Everybody that's here, this is really, truly, truly a family. And I know Kobe and Gianna and Vanessa and everybody, thank you guys from the bottom of their heart, as Kobe said. Now, I know at some point we will have a memorial for Kobe. But I look at this as a celebration tonight. This is a celebration of the 20 years of the blood, the sweat, the tears, the broken down body, the getting up, the sitting down, the everything, the countless hours, the determination to be as great as he could be. Tonight, we celebrate the kid that came here at 18 years of age. Retired at 38 and became probably the best dad that we've seen over the last 3 years, man. Tonight is a celebration. Before we get to play, love y'all, man. Kobe is a brother to me, and from the time I was in high school, to watching him afar, to getting this league at 18, watching him up close, all the battles that we had throughout my career, the one thing that we always shared is that determination to just want to win and just want to be great. And the fact that I'm here now means so much to me. I want to continue along with my teammates to continue his legacy, not only for this year, but as long as we can play the game of basketball that we love, because that's what Kobe Bryant will want. So in the words of Kobe Bryant, Mamba out, but in the words of us, not forgotten. Live on, brother.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the starting lineups for tonight's game. First, the visitors, the Portland Trail Blazers. At one guard, number 3, 6'3", 7th year out of Lehigh, C.J. McCollum. The other guard wears number 0, 6'3", 8th campaign from Weber State, Damian Lillard. At center, number 21, 7'1", 8th season from Marshall, Hassan Whiteside. At one forward, number 35, 6'9", a rookie out of Kentucky, Wenyen Gabriel. And the other forward is number 8, 6'8", 16th season from UCLA, Trevor Ariza. The head coach is Terry Stotts. And now, celebrating their 60th year in Southern California, 72nd year in the NBA, the franchise with 16 NBA titles. This is the home team, your Los Angeles Lakers. At one guard, number 24, 6'6", 20th campaign from Lower Merion High School, Kobe Bryant. The other guard is number 24, 6'6", 20th year out of Lower Merion High School, Kobe Bryant. Starting at center, number 24, 6'6", 20th season from Lower Merion High School, Kobe Bryant. At one forward, number 24, 6'6", 20th year from Lower Merion High School, Kobe Bryant. And the other forward is number 24, 6'6", 20th campaign out of Lower Merion High School, Kobe Bryant. The head coach, Frank Vogel.